So let us understand the question first. What is it? Given if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then show that it is a rectangle. What is the definition of rectangle? I gave the definition of rectangle. What it is? In a parallelogram, if one of the angles is 90 degrees, then that will become a rectangle. So already we have a parallelogram. Then if you have shown that one of the angle is 90 degree, then that will become a rectangle. So let us see how to show that. Let us say let A, B, C, D be a parallelogram. They are given. So take that one, A, B, C, D be a parallelogram. And they are given what? Diagonals of a parallelogram are equal. We find it again. AC equals to B. So now what we need to do?
These angles will become equal.
Now ABC is a parallelogram and BC is like a transversal because opposite sides of a parallelogram are parallel. So AB and CD are parallel and BC is a transversal. Then these will become which type of angles? Interior angles of the same side of the transversal are supplementary. Then by using that we get one of the angle is 90. So for that first show that these two angles, triangle, that is ABC and BCD are congruent. See, now in triangle ABC and triangle BC, what are the angles of the same? So here, parallelogram is there, opposite sides are equal. So AB is equal to CD. AB is equal to CD. This is by given because they are given parallelogram. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. I give that properties. And next, BC is equal to BC common. BC is equal to BC common because for ABC also BC is there and DC also BC is there. So BC is common. Next, they are given diagonals are equal. So what I can write? AC is equal to BD. So that is also given. So therefore, by which congruence rule this will become congruent? Side, side, side. That is, by the triangle's congruence rule, these two triangles will become congruent. So write that. two triangles are congruent, then the corresponding angles are equal. So what you can write? Angle ABC is equal to angle BC, you can write. Angle ABC is equal to angle BCB, that is by CBC. By CBC. So now, angle ABC and BBC are what? Interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. So use that. Since interior angles on the same side of the transversal of the transversal are supplementary. Are supplementary. Therefore, what you can write? Sum of these two angles. What you can write? 180 degree. So write that. Angle ABC plus angle BCD is equals to 180 degree. So now, angle ABC plus, instead of BC, I will write ABC because both angles are equal. So angle ABC, which is equal to 180 degree. So now ABC and BC. 2 angle ABC, which is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle ABC is equal to what we get 180 by 2? 90 degree. See, in a parallelogram, one of the angle is 90 degree, hence ABCD what? The rectangle. Hence, ABCD is a rectangle. So, this is the group of second main question. So, this is the next question.
BOC is equal to angle BOC. Both are right angle BOC is
CPC. Let us take this as equation 2. Now similar value, these two triangles are common. In triangle COD and triangle AOD. So what are the equations of the same? That is COA is equal to AO given. COA is equal to AO given. Next, angle COD is equal to angle AOD, both are 90 degree. Bisect each other at right angle, both are 90 degree. Next, side OD is equal to OD, common for the both the triangles. Therefore, by same rule, that is SAS, but SAS rule, triangle COD is congruent to triangle AOD. Then by same rule, what we can write? CD is equal to AD. So CD is equal to AD by CPC. Let us take this as equation. Now from equation 1, 2, 3, what you can write? See, from equation 1, 2 and 3, what you can write? See, so here it is, AB equals to BC is there. Next, BC equals to what you can write? CD. And next, CD equals to what you can write? AD. All sides are equal. Hence, ABC will become what? Rhombus. Hence, ABC is a rhombus. So, just by one congruent rule, that is by SAS. All you will get. So, this is easiest problem. Once you get the one solution, similarly you get the remaining. So then you will get all sides are equal. So this is the proof of third main question. Okay, let us